the name of this app will be the Volunteer app, and what it's going to do is allow users to look at a map near where they live and find volunteer opportunities. And so for this, I just chose four different opportunities in the Boston area, and then I set them as markers in the app. And you note that they have different little icons. So I made the carrot stand for food banks, the person for social services, and the hammer for Habitat for Humanity, so building. So the idea behind this is if I say tap on the carrot over Boston, you get a little pop-up with information about the name of the place and the volunteers. Now say I click on this one, neighbors who care, visit seniors, or work in a thrift shop. So a little bit of information. If I long click on this, so I just did a long click on that, and what it does is it takes you to a second screen with phone information and then the website below it. So you can, if you click here, call now, it will go ahead and bring that up in the phone app and you can call them directly. If you go back, it takes you back to that screen. You can, you know, go ahead and look through the website, and then if you go back, it takes you back to the map. And then you can do that for any one of them. So for instance, this one, Habitat for Humanity, calling information, and the website. So that's the general idea, and we're just going to build that right now. We're here in App Inventor, so what we're going to do is start a new project. So I'm going to click the Start New Project button. I'm going to call this Volunteer App. We're going to drag in a label for some information at the top, and then down here in the Maps drawer, we're going to pull in a map. The map, we're going to go over to its properties and set the height and width to fill parent, so it takes up the whole screen. Now for the label, we want to give them a little bit of information on how this is going to work. We are going to say click a marker for information and long click for contact information and website. Then I'm going to drag in four markers. Initially, it's not going to matter where I drag them because I'm going to move them. My map is located in Boston, so the default when you drag in a map is going to be MIT, so the Massachusetts Institute of Technology in Cambridge, Massachusetts. But you can then change the map's center to be any place near you. For instance, I actually live outside of Boston, so if you go to the map and you go to its center from string, you can put the latitude and longitude of where you live. So, for instance, I live here in Concord, Massachusetts. You can click on a location and then right-click it. And here is the latitude and longitude. And latitude and longitude is essentially the kind of coordinates for where a location is on the globe. I'm going to right-click and copy that, and if I go back to App Inventor, I can go to Center From String and paste that in. So you see that it's kind of moved over to near where I live. The other thing is that I want to zoom out. So if we look at this zoom level here, which is set to 13, if I put at 8, that might be a little bit too much zoomed out, so I'm going to say 9. Okay, so I think that's a good location because that's going to cover the area that I want to cover with my map. So what you need to do is, you know, find the central location and the latitude and longitude, and you can do that using Google Maps, and then decide on the zoom level. So the zoom level is any number from 1 to 21, I believe it is. So zooming out and zooming in to get the right zoom level that you want. The other thing you can do for the user is to say show zoom, so it will give them the plus and minus on the map so they can control a bit of the zoom themselves. There are other things like if you wanted to show the user, so it would actually show where that user is, so that's where I am located. So there's some different options there, but I'll turn that off for now. Now notice that all my markers are now clumped together here in Boston, and I'm going to move them out. So I did a bit of research and I came up with four different volunteer opportunities. Now, most likely if you wanted to create an app like this, you'd have many, many more, but this is a way to start. So what I did was I picked out four in my area and I found out their latitude and longitude by using Google Maps. So if you look here under Google Maps, so for instance here, I did a search for food banks in my area. And as you can see, there are many, many, And I picked out just two. So for instance, down here, right in Boston, is the Greater Boston Food Bank. If you right click, there's your latitude and longitude. If you click on that, it's copied to the clipboard. Then I copied and pasted that information into my latitude and longitude. It has to be separated for App Inventor, so I separated them into two columns. Then what I did was I went to their website. So from Google Maps, I could actually, go to their website, how to volunteer for them. And I grabbed that information, I put it into my spreadsheet. So gathering a bunch of information, and that's the information about volunteering, their phone number, and their website. You can grab whatever information you want for places in your area and the information that you want to convey to your users. Starting with the Greater Boston Food Bank, what I can do is I can go in here and copy the latitude. So what I'm going to do is go back to App Inventor, click on marker 1. First, I'm going to rename it. So this is Greater Boston Food Bank, so I'm just going to shorten that to GBFB. And I had copied the latitude. I'm going to paste that in there. And then I'll go back to my spreadsheet, copy the longitude, and paste that in there. And then go back, and the name is going to be my title. So if you scroll down here to the bottom of the marker properties, I can paste in that title. And then the information, I'm going to copy that, and that is going to become my description. The title and the description are what will pop up in the info box. Now the other thing is we want to enable the info box, so when the user clicks, they'll get a little pop-up. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the same thing with my other three. So I'm going to fill all that in so you can do the same on yours. Okay, now the other thing that we can do is to actually change the little icons that appear. So you can use these default, but I thought it'd be a little fun to add different icons depending on what kind of an opportunity it is. So I'm going to upload files, and I have already gathered some
images.
I actually play with them quite a bit to make them small enough, so you really want them pretty small. So for instance, this one is 50 by 43, so very small icons, because they're just going to appear on a map on a phone. So I'm going to upload my carrot and my hammer and my person. Then what I can do is say, for instance, for the Greater Boston Food Bank, here is image asset, and I can choose carrot. And the food pantry as well, I'm going to make a carrot. And for Habitat for Humanity, I'm using the hammer. And for the Neighbors Who Care, person. There is the possibility of changing the height and width, and you can set it here. Now, I had a little trouble with App Inventor doing this. They claimed it's a bug that's been fixed, but just to be sure, if you're going to choose some images, make sure that they are very small. So say 50 pixels by 50 pixels in size. And also make sure that they are transparent. So PNG files, you can have a transparent background. And that will make it look nice without this big block around it. Otherwise, you're going to have a white block around it. Here's a little tip. If you want to go to a website called remove.bg, removes background from an image, all you have to do is upload the image here, and it will make the background transparent. So you definitely want to do that. So you can see in this one, it goes from a white background to transparent. And that this little kind of checkerboard shows you that an image is transparent. So that's the website you want to use for that. Let's go back to App Inventor. We've got our four markers. So let us test this out. So I've got all four of mine set up with all the information, and you can see the icons. And if we connect to the AI companion, okay, so this is what it looks like. If I click on any one of these now, because the info box is enabled, we get the title and the description to appear. Neighbors Who Care, Habitat for Humanity, and Maynard Food Pantry. So that part is working. What we're going to do now is we're going to work on a second screen that gives a little more detail. So the ability to place a phone call to the place, to automatically volunteer, and to view the website. So we're going to have it all contained in this app.